Then I heard what sounded like a great multitude, like the roar of rushing waters, and like peals of thunder, shouting, "Hallelujah! For the Lord God Almighty reigns. Let us rejoice and be glad and give him glory, for the wedding of the Lamb has come, and his bride has made herself ready. Fine linen, bright and clean, was given her to wear. Fine linen stands for the righteous acts of God's holy people." Then the angel said to me, "Write this: Blessed are those who are invited to the wedding supper of the Lamb." And he added, "These are the true words of God." Those words come from Revelation 19, verses 6 to 9. Not long ago, I was blessed by being invited to the wedding supper of a young Amish man and his bride. It was a remarkable glimpse into a subculture of American life that outsiders rarely see. The bride and groom sat in one corner of the room while we all were served a delicious and abundant meal with four desserts, not counting the wedding cake. There appeared to be at least 200 guests in the room, and there was some talking, but mostly it was quiet. Then, before the meal, one of the men shouted a few words, not in English, and everyone bowed their heads for a couple of minutes of silent prayer. A quiet rustling let me know it was time to begin the meal. Following the meal, there was singing. It was not like any singing I had ever heard before, but it was beautiful and compelling. As a follower of Jesus Christ, I expect to receive another invitation to the wedding supper of the Lamb. I think it will in some ways remind me of my time at the wedding supper at the Amish wedding. The bride and groom will be there while we eat the feast in their honor. And the singing, I'm sure, will be like nothing I have ever heard before. It will redefine the term beautiful music. But along with the praise, there will be quiet reverence and a sense of total awe which will come over all of us who attend. Also, I can't even imagine what the food will be like at the marriage supper of the Lamb, because it will be beyond our imagination. It truly was a blessing to attend a marriage supper at an Amish wedding, but it will be a greater blessing to be invited to the marriage supper of the Lamb. And it will be one meal that you will remember forever. Lord Jesus, thank you for the joy of what is coming for those who love you and follow in your steps. How wonderful it will be, just the thought of being there at the marriage supper of the Lamb thrills my very soul. And may you, Lord Jesus, be praised now and forever. Amen.